1943年4月18日、日本軍による大規模航空作戦、伊号作戦終了に伴い、これを直接指揮していた連合艦隊司令長官山本五十六は、ブーゲンビル島、ショートランド島の前線航空基地の将兵の労を握らうべく、現地へ赴く予定を立てた。前線視察計画は艦隊司令部から各方面に打電され、当日連合艦隊参謀長宇垣まとめ中将ほか幕僚とともに2機の陸攻に分かれて登場し、予定通り6時5分にラバウルを飛び立った。
あと15分ほどでバラリ基地に到着します。
長官機ら陸攻の上空には6機のゼロ戦が護衛として配置されていた。搭乗員は第一小隊長森崎武史中尉を筆頭にラバウルのエースで構成されており、友軍勢力圏内であれと気を抜くことなく周囲に目を光らせていた。しかし彼らが朝霧に身を潜める機影に気づいたとき、それらの褐色に光る騒動を視認できるほど敵の接近を許していたのだ。
どもが畜生何キル総軍戦にしてはあまりにもできすぎてるぞ。召喚機はどこだ。くそ、こんなことをしている場合では。
危ないところだった。どうやらうまく負けたらしいな。
敵一機こっちに向かってきます。
なんだと、あの状況でつけられたとでも言うのか。直撃は、なんだ、なぜ直撃機がいない。この結末を誰が予想できただろうか。召喚機は自衛用の武装を搭載しておらず、猛攻撃を仕掛ける P-38 戦闘機を前になすすべもなく銃撃され、ブーゲンビル島のジャングルに墜落した。そして日本側は全く感知していなかったことだが、この前線視察計画は各方面に打電された時点で傍受されており、その全てを米軍によって把握されていたのだ。結果、この暗殺作戦が立案され、最終的に米軍は16機中1機が撃墜されたが任務を完遂。陸航は全機撃墜され、宇垣参謀長は生還するも、山本五十六長官は戦死した。倍の数で襲いかかる P-38 戦闘機を切り抜けた攻撃は全機帰還したが、戦死の事実は軍と国民の士気に大きな影響を与えることが予想されたため、関係者には直ちに箝口令が敷かれ、それらが公表されたのは事件からおよそ1ヶ月後の5月21日だった。召喚の最後には様々な説があるが、現在有力視されているのは墜落後も救助を待っていたが全身打撲による出血多量により命を落としたとの説で、軍刀を携えたまま泰然と戦死していたという公式発表はプロパガンダのための演出であったと考えられている。この事件により戦争の日本優位とした講和を望んでいた山本五十六の理想は完全に絶たれ、1943年以降日米の戦火は太平洋をさらに血で染めていくこととなる。
1943, April 18th. 16 B-38s were flying at 15 meters above sea level toward Bougainville Island. As they flew with fighting fatigue, they were entrusted by the U.S. military with an important operation. Operation Vengeance, an encoded Japanese military transmission intercepted 2 days earlier by SIS, the U.S. intelligence agency, indicated that Admiral Isoyoku Yamamoto was about to be transferred from the Ball to Bougainville via air escort. This was the assassination plan based on that information. A few hours later, the island of Bougainville came into view, shrouded in morning fog. Above them, as per the information, Yamamoto was flying with an escort. All was going well. Quickly, Major John Mitchell ordered the kill flight to begin combat by hand signal under radio silence so that the order would not be detected. At that moment, all aircraft dropped their tanks and began climbing at full throttle.
Betty's? Fine. We'll destroy them too. I'll do it.
Heroes, you go after the bombers. Everyone, rearrange your formation and stall the enemy. Never leave a windbreak. Let's go.
Thanks for the cover. I owe you one.
Woo!
That was too close. Buy me a drink when we get back to base.
Did the other Betty run away when it took my eyes off it? It couldn't have gone far. Wait, that's a... Yes, it seems God hasn't given up on us. Got him. Okay, the other one hit the beach if I remember right.
After confirming the crash of the G4 embedded with the number 323 on the tail, Barber headed to the beach to look for the other bomber. Meanwhile, on the beach, the kill flight, which had been taken out of the fight due to a defective drop tank, Lieutenant Busby F. Holmes and Lieutenant Raymond K. Hyde had spotted and attacked another Betty, 326. However, the airspace was disrupted by the Zeros that had suddenly broke in on the P-38 set by Major Mitchell that were chasing them. Perhaps in the midst of this chaos, Lieutenant Hyde was shot down as MIA as a result. Dodging the pursuing enemy aircraft, Lieutenant Holmes succeeds in launching another attack on the fleeing Betty. Furthermore, Lieutenant Barber, who had joined them, pursued from behind, but he lost control and crashed in the sea. After confirming that all targets had been shot down, Major Mitchell ordered all aircraft to withdraw and leave the airspace immediately. After a long-distance flight of 600 miles, the P-38 was nearly out of fuel. Lieutenant Holmes ran out of gas on the return trip and had to make an emergency landing in Russell Islands. As soon as the other planes landed at Henderson Airfield, their engines shut down. Then, Captain Lanifer reportedly radioed the base to say, that son of a bitch would not be dictating any peace terms in the White House. Later, it was discovered that the 323 was Admiral Yamamoto's plane, and there would be a dispute between the two as to whether it was Lanifer or Barber who shot it down. But what we can say without a doubt is that glory goes to all those involved in this operation.